you have grown, how your ideas could share your experience of 25 years plus.
Yes.
And so let's start from the beginning. How do you thought of starting something on your own?
See, basically this thought has came only from my own working as a employee of a very small company which is having a processed food manufacturing unit, having a very small turnover. But the major part of that turnover is an exports. Excuse me. See, it's a basically they are only mainly on the export side. But the way in which their export is not picking up, it's the main bottleneck was the government complex formalities. So I have worked there, studied their formalities, and understood what are the basic problems why the unit is not getting grow. Though there is a good vision behind them, because that unit belongs to one of the giant industrialists of Baroda, Jyoti Group. And this is the basically a food processing unit for them. And they are running in a very small way. But their vision was very clear. We wanted to cater a quality product across the globe. But just due to the complexity law, they could not do. They appointed me as one of the officer there. Then I took a guidance. I have suggested, if I am there, that's one, but I will be also needing a mentor who can suggest something on this. So after 2 years of continuous mentoring from the experts and the full support from that unit, I started learning in this. I have worked 9 years with that unit, understand the entire complexity, and then I realized if this is the problem of a one unit, means this is not a problem of the single unit, it's the problem of all the industries. So that becomes a passion for me, and day and night, the question was emerging in my mind, why I am here? Is it that I have to work only for this unit? When I have a knowledge, I have a mentor, I know the entire complex, why I should work only for a single unit? That's the key. I started my own.
So you identified a problem.
Yes.
In the market.
Correct.
There is not much of solutions available.
Yes.
You have the expertise.
Yes.
And you thought, okay, you can share your expertise to multiple level of people.
Yes.
Yeah. Now the question is, Jyoti Group knew you.
Yes.
They trained you.
Yes.
Then you came out of Jyoti Group. How do you got your first customer? Why somebody gave you that business?
See, the customer what I have got is from the food industry itself. The units which are nearby or within Baroda, they know and they are knowing how the things are there. So I started contacting them. Basically, it's a referral, not the advertisement. It's purely a referral. Today, I can very proudly say, whomsoever I have the clients, I have 100 plus clients today, but they all are with their referrals only. I have my website, but it is just for the marketing tool. As he said, today digitalize is there, so that is the reason that website is there. But the clients are coming as a referral, and because it speaks on the referrals.
So you get references because of your
yes.
The kind of service you are providing to the people.
Yes. Initially, I started with the 3 clients, those who are very well connected with that group and very close in that nature. All the three were the manufacturer. They wanted to start at their own manufacturing, and one guy who is very keen to start the export business as a merchant exporter. And I started that as a challenge. He doesn't know what to do. I said, don't worry, you just concentrate on getting the order, execution, leave it on me. Then I started everything.
So do you work with the organization as a mentor or as a guide, or is it pure service?
Pure services as well as a mentor. Today, I can very proudly say, all my clients, I am training at least one executive in that company, so that over a period my responsibility will be there, but our clerical work will be reduced to that extent.
So, don't you think you are not afraid that you may lose?
No.
Any particular reason that, okay, if you train somebody, because this is a challenge.
Yes.
Most of the, like, if I train somebody,
yes,
in the organization,
yes,
he will take care of the entire job, and I, as an expert from outside, will lose that particular client.
See, that today, even the MNCs or the corporate world need an advisor. Professional advisors are there. Whether or not they have their own HR team, whether or not they have a very good marketing, very good finance team, everything is there, still they need an advisor. Why? That's the reason. Advisor is an advisor. He is the basically giving a continuous training, and when there is a problem, he is the only person who is clearing the solution. The person who has been trained, he has been trained to that level, not to having that day-to-day updation on that part, the policy provisions. What we provide is a day-to-day updation and how to manage that problem. This basic USP is that.
Now you talked about you have presence in the website. Can you just tell me, like, everybody is talking about digital, and digital is one of the key requirements.
Yeah.
How digital ready you are? What are the things you are doing to ensure that your organization is digital ready and can move and seamlessly integrate with the current economy?
See, in my office, now majority work is purely on the computer, and even on my website, I have put one link whereby any person has any question, basic question related to the exports or import business, he can just put a question, and within 24 hours he will get his answer. This is how I started that website. Main use of the website from my angle is for this purpose, to reach the people who are not in a physical vicinity of our own office reach. So even from the global, I am getting the now questions. If anybody wants to invest in India, what are the brief things that I am replying on emails on through my website itself? So this is the main thing are there. And in my office, each and every person, all the employees have been given a proper impart training on the computer usage, and they all have been given the internet access, because my basic work is working only on the internet. Because all the government applications I am handling in-house on behalf of my clients. I am representing my clients at all the government department as if we are the employee and the executive of that particular company. My client need not have to appoint their employee for representing any problem with the government department. We are taking that care.
So how many people are working with you? Understand, well, you are not a very large organization, if I understand.
Today we have 11 people, of which 3 are on the second line management.
Okay. Now this is again a question which I need to understand, which I have seen a lot of people were saying is very difficult to get the right kind of people to join an organization. So how are you able to get, and can you just tell me what is the average iteration rate? Like how long they used to work with you? Is it like delay within 2 months, 3 months, 1 year?
The 3 management people with whom I am now blindly trusting what the previous speakers had said, the transferability and the things, this is what I have done. Today I am sitting here, I have not received any single call from my any of the client regarding any problem, because my office is very well prepared to answer them. And all that 3 guys who are working with me in a second line management, they are with me since more than 7 years. I have appointed them as a totally a raw person having no knowledge on the exports. I have trained them, nurtured them, and today they are taking care of my own organization.
That's really appealing and really very good that I think. So 7 years.
This is the part of my training part.
That's very good. I really appreciate. And so now you're 25 years.
Yeah.
Business has always comes goes up, goes down.
Yes.
So can you tell me that few challenges that you face, and how do you have been able to overcome these challenges?
See, the challenges are that initially, yes, it was very much difficult because I have left the organization for one cause. The day on which I have given a resignation, not a single client was on paper with me to start this. So first 1.5 years, I have worked, worked with them without having name and anything. After 1.5 years of working, I have floated the company, the name Prattles Professional Services. The struggle which initially I had, I do not want to just mention, it is everybody's business part of the game, that it has to be that struggle. The only thing to overcome that struggle is the mindset. I always pray the God, yes, I can do it. Any struggle without having anything that think it is a struggle, I always take that as an additional opportunity to grow. That's the thing. To every day morning, yes, the first word which I am saying is, yes, I can do today, and today is my day. This is the my theory.
Where do you look at your organization 5 years? Are you looking at expansion and increase your number of people, having branches in different places?
Frankly speaking, I am not interested in opening a branch in any other city, because nowadays we can cater globally over the network and the emails. So hiring a people and opening is any branch in a particular city, it's nothing but an additional infrastructure investment. And to manage that particular infrastructure investment is nothing but an additional cost to the organization, which I do not want to increase. Yes, I have my associate offices in 7 cities of the India. That includes the 3 metros, Chennai, Mumbai and Delhi.
And let's understand, this is something very important for any businesses. How are you planning for succession? How are you ensuring that the baton is passed to the next generation? Are you getting your team ready, or your management team, the second generation is ready, or you have plans within your family to take the baton and move just to the next level?
As I explained, I have a 3-pillar with me in the second line, and I am very much confident about that this 3-pillar will take over in a future. Apart from that, my elder daughter, who has done the similar line study in India as well as in London, she is working presently in London in the same field. She is an air freight manager working with the one very reputed logistic company, and gradually after 7 or 10 years, she will be migrated back and she will take over my business. This is what my plan is.
That's good. So you have planned for next 5 years?
Yes. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Something for us to know.
See,
and plan.
When I am planning for my clients in a success growth, and I am just giving the roadmap to everything, it's for me also, I have to plan my own roadmap for my own company. Because, see, the future is there. This complexity will remain will be there. No entrepreneur in the world is such a person without any of the advisor or the service provider, he can manage his business.
So let's understand that, and let's get few points from you. Like if a young entrepreneur is starting a business, what a kind of thing he need to do? From your experience, please share something. You've been meeting not many people, so please share some experience.
See, the first and foremost is that entrepreneur who is young and who wanted to be an entrepreneur. He has to have his own passion to be an entrepreneur. Number one. Number two, he should be very well matured to work at any level, right from opening of the office, cleaning of the office, to going and attending that meeting and to client, and that is also well within the time schedule as per the client. And number third, he should have his own courage to face any of the difficulty, whether it is ups or downs or that, And even though if it is a comfort job, don't just sleep as a comfort. That should be the success story.
Mr. Shah, thank you very much. I'm sure his experience, the way he has built his organization has really helped. One last question before we wrap up. You have been very well networked.
Yeah.
You use different platform for networking. Please enlighten us and suggest how this networking platform is important. How being participating in different and getting awarded in all the places is important. Is that helpful for you in businesses?
Yes. See, in today's world, for growing any one business, networking is the only tool I can say. Even though you have a very good marketeer, even though you have a very good marketing team, sales team, very nice website develop, very nice social media connect, but as a owner or the entrepreneur, if you are not connecting to the people, your business has a one stop. If you wanted to continue that, you be in a limelight, meet the people, train them, and do your own presence in each and every meeting. The networking is the only solution.
Thank you, sir. Really appreciate that.